What is VPN? I'm sure a lot of you have come across the term VPN when trying to access region-based content, right? Content that's blocked in your area, but you want to use it because it's available somewhere else. But have you ever understood what it actually is and how it works? I'm Pooja from IBM, and I'm here to explain what VPN is. VPN, Virtual Private Network. That's what VPN stands for. But what does it essentially mean here? So virtual, meaning no hardware or cables. Private, talking about privacy, right? Which is very important when you're accessing the internet. And network, which is devices on the internet, right? And to go into the technical definition of VPN, what we have to see and understand is VPN establishes a secure digital connection, and meaning there is a secure tunnel where your data is actually transferred through, and this data is encrypted, and it also masks your IP address, thus preserving your anonymity in the web. What is an IP address, right? So IP address is an internet protocol address. And every device on the internet has a unique one associated with it, with which we identify the device. Let's understand the real-time use of VPN. Let's say there is a user, Sam, and Sam is in a coffee shop. He now realizes he forgot to send an important work email. So what he does, he connects to the public Wi-Fi that's there. And then he connects to the target web server, which could be the bank server, or it could be his work emails that he's trying to send. So it could be anything important that he forgot about through the day, right? What happens is Sam now sends all his data through the internet to the actual target web server. And this data has his IP address, his information like bank details, his work emails, his logins, all of those things. Well, this is where something interesting happens. Now there is a hacker possibly observing all of this in a passive way. So he's probably trying to do a passive cyber attack here. So the next day, there is a possibility Sam's bank balance could be zero, or Sam's work emails are hacked. Anything can happen because the hacker now has information that is really important and for Sam's access for things, right? But what happens when we use a VPN? So this one is without VPN, right? So now let's see what happens when we actually use a VPN in this entire setup. That will help us understand how VPN is really important, right? So let's say now Sam has a VPN client. So he has installed it in his device. And now what the VPN does is it now creates a secure tunnel. So this secure tunnel actually transfers the information in an encrypted way. So the VPN has various protocols that it uses to encrypt this data, right? And now he actually goes to the VPN server. It doesn't go to the web server, if you notice that. So it goes to the VPN server here. And what the VPN server does is it decrypts the data. So it has the encryption key and it decrypts the data. And what the VPN server does is it puts its own IP address in the place of Sam's IP address. And now it connects to the actual web server, right? And what happens here in the secure tunnel, right? This is where all of the users, the internet service provider, any government agencies that's tracking you, that's observing all your information, and advertisers, they are all looking at this information, right? So what they see is now a bunch of gibberish. So they cannot actually get any information about you to bombard you with ads. So that way, your information is preserved. With the IP being preserved, and when we switch out to the VPN's IP address, what the web server actually sees is the VPN's IP address and not your own IP address. So that way, your IP is masked or spoofed and your location is preserved. Now, when we spoke about the real-time example, remember about online streaming? Let's say Sam is in the US. He wants to access something that's available only in Europe. So he connects to the VPN server that's in Europe. And now the VPN server mimics as though Sam is in Europe itself, and he's able to access content that's available only for Europe users, right? So this is how VPN is being used almost on an everyday basis. So big companies use VPN, banks use VPN, employees from multinational corporations use VPN. So it's almost everywhere. And a lot of people use VPN even in their homes to protect their personal and private data, right? So there are many types of VPN prevalent now. The most important ones are like the remote access VPN and the site-to-site VPN. So I'm going to talk only about those two today. Remote access VPN is, as the word says, it's basically for remote access, meaning when, let's say, an employee of a company is traveling and he's commuting for work, for anything, doesn't matter to us. So, but he wants to access private resources and files from the private network of his company. What all he has to do is he has to log into the VPN client with the secure credentials and then connect to the private network. Now he has access to all the resource files and the data that's there on the private network. And the next one is actually the site-to-site VPN. With the site-to-site VPN, this is mostly used by the large companies that's out there. Imagine they have multiple branches located in different locations, right? So they need something interlinked. They need network connectivity between these different branches. They use site-to-site VPN to access each other's data. And to conclude, overall, right, let's talk about the uses of VPN, or basically the advantages, right? The uses of VPN here. Here first, your anonymity, right? So what happens is your IP is masked or spoofed, right? IP spoof is happening. So your geolocation is protected and all your private data is encrypted. So your anonymity on the web is preserved, thus giving you a better privacy and security. And now you can access firewall blocked content, right? Any regional based content, anything that you wouldn't normally be able to access just by using your own public Wi-Fi. And that's pretty much all the uses of VPN. And I hope this video was really informational. Thank you. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or want to share your thoughts about this topic, please leave a comment below.